So late breaking this noon, we expect some of those arrested locally in the statewide investigation into illegal gambling to go in front of a Seminole County judge this afternoon. Several locations affiliated with Allied Veterans of the World were hit with search warrants yesterday, while 57 people involved with Allied Veterans face arrest.
WESH 2'S Dave McDaniel joins us live this noon outside the Seminole County Jail, where initial court appearances are set for this afternoon. Dave.
You know, Jason, this is such a lengthy investigation. It started in 2009. It involves dozens of suspects all across the state of Florida and really all across the country. And we have all these charges. We have illegal gambling. We have racketeering. We have money laundering being alleged by the state. This is such a massive case, such a large number of suspects. It should play out in court for some time to come. While investigators evaluate what's on at least some of the computer hard drives seized from a handful of internet cafe locations, it's what's on the computer screens, the games people played, that has so many people accused of illegal activity. Allied Veterans of the World and its leaders are accused of claiming to sell internet time while running illegal gambling houses instead.
We've uncovered a multi-state illegal gambling, money laundering, and racketeering scheme.
And authorities say the group claimed to give massively to charity while pocketing most of the cash as profit instead.
The co-conspirators exploited veterans to line their own pockets with illicit proceeds. They've made expensive purchases, buying a multitude of properties, boats, and cars.
An attorney for at least some of those arrested says the state isn't being fair.
If there's been a crime, why would law enforcement allow the business to exist for 6 years? 6 years, imagine that, 2,000 days. These businesses have existed, and nobody arrested anybody. And then miraculously, one day it becomes illegal?
Investigators say they felt the locations always were in violation, but it simply took a while to build a case. Now, initial appearances are scheduled for 1:30 this afternoon at the Seminole County Jail. Some people who were supposed to make initial appearance yesterday in this case were carried over to today because of procedural issues yesterday. So it's not exactly clear how many are going to go. Others who were arrested in other counties were brought here because they were Seminole County warrants. We may have a couple of dozen people in all going in front of a judge this afternoon. Reporting live in Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.
Thank you, Dave.